Good evening, everybody. I had a prepared speech and I've forgotten every bit of it the moment I saw Shahrukh. And I'm going to try to make a good impression on him and try to say something so that he actually believes what Rohit said, that I am actually a good faculty at IIPM. So we're not going to have a formal speech. What I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you some questions. Are you ready for that? Let's make it a little interactive. Is everybody ready for that? Questions? Ready for the answers? Okay, I'm going to shoot some lines. Tell me what comes into your mind when you hear those lines. Everybody okay? Okay, first line. Kitne aadmi the? Chole? Okay, that's the correct answer. Now that you're getting warmed up, the second line. Tell me what comes into your mind when you hear this. A brand name, a company name, a movie name, whatever. Kitne aadmi ko text karna hai? Kitne aadmi ko text karna hai? Blackberry? Okay, we'll do the answering later on. Second line. Taste ka sawal hai. Taste ka sawal hai. Any brand that you can think of? Cadbury, okay, so that's a Blackberry and a Cadbury. It's getting into a rhyming mode. Another line. Let's get some bang in the bhangra. Any brand you can think of? Let's get some bang in the bhangra. Any brand you can think of? I didn't hear of that one. Okay, Golden Temple Atta brand. Golden Temple Atta brand. Anything that comes to your mind? Amritsar? Which was the first company to give free email? This is an easy one. Which was the first company to give free email? Hotmail? Yahoo? I guess Hotmail was louder, so we'll go for Hotmail. The first company to make disposable diapers. Huggies? Pampers? So there's a fight there, a tie there. The first company to start selling books online. Amazon? Amazon.com, 100% sure. Okay, there are many more, but then let's stop it at this. Sorry to say, all the answers were wrong. Surprised. And that's what actually marketing is all about. Because what we believe is actually not what it is. I'll give you the answers very quickly. It was not Hotmail that gave the first free email. It was a company called Juno. We don't even remember it. Taste ka sawal hai. Is a leaflet that McDonald's sends to all its customers in America. Kitne aadmi ko text karoge? Is a Canadian company that is advertising its SMS rates called Roger. Pampers or Huggies were not the first to make disposable diapers. It was a company called Chucks. We don't even remember those names. We don't want to remember those names because they're extinct and gone and they mean nothing to us. And that's exactly what is the purpose of this book. That if you are not aggressive and if you do not give thorns to your competition, you will be the answers to a question. You will never exist in the mind of the consumer. So T-H-O-R-N-S. Each of these six words stands for one principle. Very, very quickly, let's go through the principle. T stands for target. You need to know whom you are hitting at. And remember, either you are number one or number two. The consumer does not remember a third number. So if you really have to matter in the business, then you either be number one or number two. Below that, I'm sorry, I have no space in my mind for you. And those who failed to target, understand their target correctly, actually lost out in the share. Whoever thought that Detroit would be bankrupt? Whoever thought that the big three would be bankrupt? But they are, because they forgot their target. They forgot that oil prices were rising. They forgot that American families were getting smaller. They needed small cars, fuel-efficient cars. And in came Toyota, in came the Japanese cars, captured the market, and they are today dead and gone. Leaders are overthrown every day. After the World War II, nobody wanted Japanese products. Akio Morita went to Japan with his transistor, and the only problem he had was not the quality of the transistor. The problem was nobody wanted to buy a transistor, however good it is, if it had "Made in Japan" written on it. From that moment to a day when Sony is the most loved brand, things have changed because there are some people who have kept an eye on the target. So that's T. H, hit where it hurts. If you really have to make it, and if you really know, the bottom line for all the six principles is the same. Please make sure your product is good first. And second, whatever you do, please do it ethically, otherwise you'll never survive. So hit it where it hurts. If you are sure of your product, go on, hit out at the competitor. In fact, some people have been so sure of their product that they have said, I'm going to pay my consumers to go and try out a competitor's product and they will come back to me. Dunkin' Donuts in America gave $100 coupons to its customers and said, go on and buy things at Starbucks. None of them liked it. They all came back. That's the power of believing. That's the power of being aggressive. Whoever thought that you could actually promote your competitor's product, you can only do that when you're absolutely sure of the product that you have in hand. Hit where it hurts, but hit it correctly. If you go wrong, and if you're not sure, and if your product is weak, and if you don't hit at the weakest spot, you might just fall out. It's not a game for the weak-hearted. Oh, obsess. Obsess about your consumer. And this is what we felt, that when you go back to the class with examples that are even 5 years old, nobody's interested. This is, what are you talking about? This is not the way we live. Because your consumer today is totally different. Your consumer does not farm in the villages. He farms in Farmville. Your consumer, for him, Hotmail is no more hot. He is Facebooking. He does not go to a shop directly. He first goes online. In fact, he doesn't even watch a movie before he reads its reviews online. That's the new consumer of today. The 15 to 25-year-olds, this generation is the most different generation we've ever seen. And as marketers, it is our responsibility, it's our duty to understand them. Because if I don't understand them, they don't care about me. It's a don't know, don't care generation. N, nail it. Sorry, R. We missed out on one. R. And R, the most important. Reinvent. Keep changing. Everything in the marketplace is changing. It is not the most intelligent of the species or the strongest of the species that has survived. It is the one that is most adaptable. Remember the dinosaurs. So just because you're big today, just because you're a leader today, does not mean you will survive till you don't adapt, till you don't change constantly. Keep reinventing your product. N is nail it. You have to make sure that however good your product, if the consumer does not remember it in his minds. When I say Nike, what do you think of? Just do it. Anywhere, just do it means Nike. It's nailed into your heads, and that's the intelligence of the marketer. I nail an image, I nail a word, I nail a feeling into your mind. Chanel number 5 was not a perfume, was just an ordinary perfume till Marilyn Monroe said, the only thing I wear to bed is Chanel number 5. And from that day onwards, it was nailed. Its image was nailed in the minds of the competitors, consumers, and nobody could shake it. Whatever your image, nail it in the minds of the consumer. Apple, what is the thing you think of first? Think different, and that's Apple for you. That's the image. Irreverence, iconic, that's the image of Apple for you. Beetle nailed it. It was the most ugly car, and yet, think small, the first thing you think of is Beatles. Till 1948, neither engagements nor marriages were associated with diamond rings. And then one company came and nailed it into your minds that, look, a diamond is forever. I know a lot of husbands would not be liking that, but from that day onwards, there can be no marriage, there can be no engagement without a diamond ring. Nailing it into the minds of the competitors, consumers, everybody. S, sell it. Everything said and done. Finally, you have to make sure you sell your product. And sell it, make it fun, enjoyable. There are so many ways of selling your product. But remember one thing, very, very important, as I said in the beginning also, and it's a part of our book, repeatedly. Whenever you sell, keep ethics in mind. And before I end, two role models that for every marketer. If you have to understand Thorns, understand these two people. They're two strange names. Mahatma Gandhi and Lady Gaga. Absolutely unrelated, but those are the two role models because they understood and they followed the philosophy which we today call Thorns. Target your consumer. Gandhi knew Indians will never come out of on the streets and fight a bloody revolution. So he says, walk. And everybody was ready to walk. Hit it where it hurts. Hit the Britishers, find where the weakness is, boycott their products, hit them exactly where it hurts, weave your own cloth. Obsess about your consumer. He was obsessed about India, he knew India very well, reinvent yourself, he changed his whole ways, his look, he was never wearing what he used to wear. He used to be dressed as a Britisher when he was practicing law. But then, if I have to nail that message, and he used to nail that message with the beautiful words which got the country together, then I have to reinvent myself. And everything he said, he marketed it so well. It sells even today. Every Gandhian philosophy sells. Think of Munna Bhai MBBS, think of the Gandhi topi that Anna Hazare used, and everything sells even today. And what about Lady Gaga? She knows her target audience absolutely well. Different from Gandhi, but yes, her target audience is the 10 to 15 year olds. She calls them little monsters, and they love it. Because they want to be different, they want to be cool, and that little monster sounds so cool, and they go to the monster ball, they don't go to the rock concert. She hits them where it hurts. She's targeted it so well. She obsesses about them, she obsesses about her product, she obsesses about her consumers. She writes her own lyrics, she makes her own music, she does her own videos, she designs her own clothes, and every act of her is rehearsed. She wants to be weird. And if I ask anybody, what is the first thought that comes in your mind? They say, born this way. That's the thought she has nailed into the minds of the consumers. That look, don't be scared to be weird. Don't be scared just because you don't fit in. Because we're all born this way and let's be proud of it. And that lady knows how to sell. I was reading a biography and she mentioned an incident where it said, that early days of her career, she was playing piano at a bar full of drunken students. Obviously, nobody was interested in the piano that she was playing, but she was playing so that people listen, not for the pleasure of music. If she makes a record, she makes sure she's going to sell it, and she will go to any extent to sell it. And when she saw nobody was listening to her, she undressed. And suddenly, everybody was listening to her. Go the way. If you really have to succeed and if you want success to be yours, give thorns to your competition, and that's the only way to really, really survive. Aggression is what we have emphasized on, and those are your six quick looks at the book. In the end, to survive, you need to stand out. To survive, you need to shout out. Shout out your message, stand out, be different. To survive, you need to look out, watch for the new trends. Stand out, shout out, look out, or else be prepared to be shut out. And that's the philosophy behind this book. Do everything, make sure your product is good, do it with ethics, do it with the correct marketing strategies, and you're bound to be successful. This is what we have tried to put in the book. And we hope you enjoy reading it. But while I was writing this book, a sense of gratitude, a sense of a deep sense of happiness. And before I end, I would really, really want to thank a few people who have today made me what I am. First of all, my parents, for making me who I am, showing me what it is to be independent, to do what you want to do, and most importantly, to never be scared of failing. My brother, he thinks I'm the best writer in the world, and I love him for that. Not many people do that, think that. My very, very, very supportive family, especially my father-in-law, we're talking so much about ethics. And it's all that I learned when I entered into IIPM and I attended his classes. And that's when I saw the world from a different eye. Because here was a man who was teaching me business, but he was telling me that, look, business is nothing if you cannot do something for somebody who is not as privileged as you are. The one man whose whole life is dedicated towards working for the underprivileged, whatever he does, the first thought that comes to mind is, if I'm doing anything, how is it going to help the bottom 20%? And that bottom 20% has become the most important part of everything that we do today. My mother-in-law, most talented, most hardworking. I look at her and I get inspired. My sister-in-law, my brother-in-law, wonderful people. One very special person, Abhimanyu Ghosh, CEO of Power Brands. I cannot forget the day when he came to me and said, ma'am, please write a column in this journal. And he pushed me and I started writing. And it's the result of that one day that he came to me that today I love writing so much. I look forward to the feedback I get of all my readers in the 4P's magazine that I write for regularly. I thank you, Abhimanyu, for getting me started on that. Thank you, Deepak, for telling that a book written by me and Arundham is actually going to work. You gave us the faith and you actually pushed us into doing that. Thank you, Stephen. Every New Year message, you tell me, ma'am, when is your book coming? I hope this New Year's, I will not get that message again because the book's already there. Thank you, everybody who has been here. Thank you, Shahrukh. You're the most inspiring. The work you do, the amount of work you do behind the scenes, which we come to know, the amount of hard work you put in, and the amount of sincerity with which you take up everything is absolutely awe-inspiring. Every time I enter the class, I tell my students that he's not a superstar for nothing. There is a lot of toil, a lot of labor that has gone on to make this man what he is. And we truly respect you. Thank you so much for always being a part of every activity of ours. And last but not the least, if I can stand here and speak, it's because of one person. Years ago, I won't tell you how many years, but when my first class at IIPM, I had to give my speech. I was shivering. I don't know what I spoke. It made no sense. And there was this teacher whom I really wanted to impress, and I made an utter fool of myself. And then he came and said, look, you're very good. And you won't believe it, that was the happiest day of my life. I knew I was pathetic, but his feedback made me feel so good. And even today, his feedback is the most important thing for me. Everything I do, I just wait first for his feedback. And that's none other than my co-author, my friend, my partner, Arundham. Thank you so much. He believed in my writings, and which is why we have a book together again, because he is a perfectionist and he will not just write a book because I'm his wife, but he will write a book only because he believes that what I write makes sense. And I'm so glad that what I write makes sense. And I guess that's what completes the list. It's almost as if an Oscar-winning speech. But thank you so much, everybody. That's what the book is all about. And we do hope you enjoy reading it. Thank you.